This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, now here you go with. Let's understand about chained case types. Okay, let me explain this again. So the instantiation process automatically by system when parent case vehicle insurance starts, meaning that chained case gets created whenever the parent case has been created. Okay, suppose if you give a condition here, the condition will be verified at the beginning of the parent case instantiation. When the parent case is instantiated, given this condition satisfied, child will be created, else will not be created. During the processing, anytime this condition is satisfied, still child case will not be created. Okay, suppose if you go with second option of whenever the parent case starts and given all conditions are met, if you add conditions here, then child case will get created when all of these conditions are met at the beginning or during the process. This is clear. This is how instantiation process. Now let's discuss about work objects. Those are parent and child work objects. By clipboard, let's go to clipboard. Parent work object is V-129. Parent work object is, oh, I'm sorry. Okay, for our better understanding, let's change the prefixes for child work object, because parent and child having same work object ID prefix will get create a confusion. For verification, I'm giving VEF. I'm giving VEF. Here you go with create. I'm creating a parent case, and immediately, as per my options chosen, child cases will be created. Two child cases, VEF1 and A14. Okay. Now here you go to clipboard. For verification case, first we'll go. Now you tell me, as you are already aware of this, work object data will be available on clipboard on which page? PY work page, that you are aware of. Work object data will be available on clipboard on PY work page. Everyone clear with this? Is it for same for parent and child? Is it generic or parent different, child different? Work object data will be available on clipboard on PY work page irrespective of whether it is parent or child. Now tell me, total how many PY work pages will be there? Three PY work pages, one for parent, one for child, one for child 2. Is it available within the scope of same work object, or it will be available for all work objects? Within the scope of single work object, PY work page will be available, or PY work page will be exposed to other work objects also? So one work object PY work page, can you expose to other work objects as it is? Possible or not possible? Not possible. So every work object will have its own PY work page referring to its own instance classes. This is instance class for vehicle insurance, is where it has started instantiation process. Okay, for parent work object, PY work page is there referring to vehicle insurance. Let's talk about child work objects. Where is it? VEF1. I'm sorry, is that approval or what? Okay. Verification. Okay, VEF verification. What class PY work page is referring to? PY work page is referring to which class? Verification class. This PY work page and other PY work page which we have seen for parent, both are same or different? Both are completely different. So PY work page of parent is created in its own scope referring to its own case type class. Similarly, for child case, PY work page is created in its own scope referring to its own case type class. Similarly, go to approval. Ready? Approval. For approval also, case is created, it's within the scope of, PY work page is created within the scope of approval class, case type class. Everyone clear? So every work object will have its own PY work page. Each work object data will be available on its own PY work page only. Everyone clear? Now, if you go to child case, you have a page called PY work cover. PY work cover page referring to which class? Vehicle insurance. On this page, work object ID is V-131. That is the object ID of what? Parent work object. Now here you go with verification. For verification also, apart from PY work page, we have another page called PY work cover referring to same. Now you go to parent case. For parent case, do you have any PY work cover? PY work page is there. Do you have any PY work cover? No. So if you get any idea, just tell me, what is that PY work cover available at child cases? So child case, both child cases, you have 10 child cases, 10 will have Viva work cover. Same Viva work cover will be available on turn 10. So now what is the page all about Viva work cover? That is copy of which page? Parent case Viva work. Parent case Viva work page is made available by default. It is made available to all children. Can it make it available with the same name as Viva work page? Is it possible? One work cover having two Viva work pages is possible? No. So copy of the Viva work page of parent case is been made available to all children with what name? PY work cover. You know what is the meaning of cover? Cover work means cover work object. Cover work means cover object. Cover means parent. Same name, meaningfully they have given. PY work cover at all child cases is a copy of PY work page of parent case. That means data of parent case is made available to all children. Okay, now let me ask you one question. This is the child case type. Let's say for example, here I have added a utility. In the utility activity, can I access the data of parent work object? I am creating a utility activity here. Using utility activity, I wanted to set PY child work object with the data from parent work object. You tell me the step. Property set I have added. Inside property set, my intention is some properties of parent object I wanted to assign to child case work object properties. What are the steps inside property set? What do you write? What you will be writing? Property set local name raster. Left side what you write, right side what you write. I wanted some properties of parent work object to be assigned to child work object properties. For that, I am creating an activity in child case type where I am writing property set. Inside what you write?
Primary dot py work cover.
Right side, you tell me right side what is that? From where we are assigning is right side. Okay. Parent work object data. Where you read it from? Where are you going to read the parent work object data from? PY work cover dot some property will be assigned to PY work page dot some property. If you write property set, property set. Now PY work page dot property 1 is equal to సార్ నేను క్లాస్ లో ఉన్న ఒక 10 మినిట్స్ తర్వాత చేస్తానండి పర్లేదు పిఐ వర్క్ కవర్ డాట్ ప్రాపర్టీ 1 వాట్ డస్ దిస్ మీన్ వి ఆర్ గెట్టింగ్ ద డేటా ఆఫ్ పేరెంట్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ అసైన్డ్ టు చైల్డ్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ సపోజ్ నో పేరెంట్ నో చైల్డ్ సిమిలర్లీ ఇఫ్ ఐ వాంటెడ్ టు అసైన్ ద డేటా ఆఫ్ సెకండ్ చైల్డ్ టు ఫస్ట్ చైల్డ్ ఇస్ ఇట్ పాసిబుల్ లైక్ దిస్ యు హావ్ ఎనీ వన్ చైల్డ్ వర్క్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ డేటా ఇస్ ఇట్ మేడ్ అవైలబుల్ టు అదర్ చైల్డ్ వర్క్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్స్ By default, do you have any such pages?
No.
Not available. Suppose given I am asking you, within one, while you are processing one work object, you have to write an activity in that work object somewhere. It should open another work object and get the data and add it to current work object. What are the steps you write? I wanted to get the data of other work object and assign to current work object. For that, you need to write a utility activity in your workflow. Create and add it. What are the steps in the activity? This is basic question. You are passing the work object ID value, that and all is okay. Other than that, given work object ID value you are passing, what are the steps in the activity? Right.
Page new.
We have to create a page.
I am not asking page new, page copy, leave it. Tell me the important step which we have to write. Page new, okay. You have done page new. Next.
Then property set page copy.
Property set page copy will give what? Where is the data first of all? Can this current work object get the data of other work object easily directly? Can it access? No. It has to access the data of other objects. How to access? By using what? Which method we have to use? What method we have to use? OBJ, either you go ahead with OBJ browse and browse only one work object or OBJ open and open the other work object. from work of one work of date, if you want to access the data of other work of date, which method you will use? You have to go ahead and use OBJ, open or open by handle. Between child work of dates, the accessibility is not there. If you wanted to access the data of other child into current child, then that object ID you should know, first of all, that should be passed, and you have to do either OBJ open without acquiring the lock or OBJ open by handle without acquiring the lock or browse by passing the PYID value. Either of these you have to do. But that and all is eliminated from parent to child. Parent to child, do you need to do OBJ open and all? Parent child or child to child, different cases only, right? You don't need to do OBJ open or OBJ open by handle. Instead of Pega has internally implemented this all this concept and giving the data dumped onto PY work cover, directly take it from PY work cover, done. You wanted to access the data of other child means what you have to do? You have to do OBJ open. Okay, now let me ask you another question. I wanted to write an activity in parent case to access the data of child work update assigned to parent work update. Is it directly possible? Is it possible directly or not? It is not possible directly. Because parent can look up child, is it possible? From parent, can you look up child? It is not possible. Then what you have to do? You have to do OBJ open or OBJ open by handle. Only parent can directly get the content of child. I'm sorry. Child can directly get the content of parent through PY work cover. Here and there, vice versa, or other child work cover data, no other go. You have to go ahead and use OBJ open by handle activity you write. Instead, you write those activities. Pega has come up with OOTP solution. That is called, just for your information, chapani ikkada edi meaningful ga undi, update a case. What do you mean by update a case? Update a case and pass the ID, whether it is parent or child, whatever it can be. Accordingly choose options one or more, okay, and pass the ID, PY ID of current one. This is a single case. You write a data transform, no worries. Okay, and property set, property 1, property 2, you not need not to define pages. Property 1, property 2, property 2, property 3, like this. Now that other work object what you are going to give here will be opened automatically from the database and it will update with the current work object. So update a case is going to update the current work object with the data of any other work object when you use this flow shape. Here, what is eliminated? You are not needed to write OBJ open, OBJ open. Only thing is pass the parameter of ID value of from where you wanted to take the data, other work object ID value. Then you are not needed to write OBJ open. PRPC will internally do this. Flow shape is nothing but OBJ open property set or OBJ browse property set or OBJ open handle property set accordingly. Because you are passing class key here, this must be OBJ open and property set internally, this flow shape. Okay, so that is what about updating, how to update the data from parent into child. We already aware of all the process of using OBJ open, OBJ open by handle, OBJ browse. Accordingly, with your knowledge, you have to design this. Suppose given business is asking, you write an activity at your child case design, you copy the data from parent and add it to child. If you write OBJ open and all, that means you do not have knowledge about PY work cover. If you have knowledge about PY work cover, then you will directly do property set from PY work cover to PY work page of current work object. So knowing PY work cover here is important. And internal logic is again same OBJ open, OBJ open handle or whatever it is. So if you wanted to get the data of other work objects, then PY work cover concept will not work. Then you have to do OBJ open and all. Instead of that, you go ahead and use update case. Internally it will do the same OBJ open handle, OBJ open without locking, and then data transform you write down property 1 is equal to property 2, property 3 is equal to property 4. It will copy from page to page for specific properties. Everyone clear with this? All these practicals we have done, only concepts wise we have to know what is provided available already. Next, same another concept is business is asking, let's say you have created parent case, child cases get expanded sometime later, let's say, or maybe immediately, whatever it is. In the parent case, you have new harness. Let's say you have new harness, you are trying to pull some data from the new harness from database and make it available for parent work object. Just imagine this data, I wanted to give it to child cases also. The moment child case gets created, what is the data available with parent? I wanted to give it to child case. Giving it to child case means making it available on the PY work page of child case. Means by the time child case creates, this data what is available on PY work cover should be landing onto PY work page of child case. For this, we can implement like where I can do this assignment. Data assigning from parent to child while child is getting instantiated the moment. That is by default it has to be assigned. In which rule we can do this? In which rule? You understand the question? Question is parent case you created, two child have been spanned. When you are creating parent case, it has some data from new harness. Some data. That data also should be given to child cases. That is the requirement. For that you have to do property set. Somewhere you have to do property set. The property set should be executed while the child case is getting created. That property set should be completed and case should be created. That means this property set should be written in some rule. Which rule it has to be written?
Data page.
Data page of property set. First of all, that property set will copy the data from PY work cover to PY work page. That you are aware of, right? But somewhere you have to write this property set logic, right? Where would you write? In which role? What is the name of the data transform? You have to write it in PY default data transform. Where is the PY default data transform available? The PY default data transform should be created, copied from parent class to this child classes and all. Specific child classes, PY default data transform should be available, case type class. And in the data transform, you have to, if you write something in PY default data transform, that gets executed before the case gets created. Right? This is what we have learned. Other than this, there is another approach provided by PEGA. Don't touch PY default data transform. Look at here. If you go to parent case type, there is an option available. What is that? Data propagation. Data propagation. Data propagation, propagate the data means copy the data from current case, parent case to different child cases, one or more. Add property or apply data transform. You apply data transform in this data transform. You do property 1 is equal to property 1, property 2 is equal to property 2, property 3 is equal to property 3. Like this, you do it inside data transform. When this will be executed? The moment parent case creates, child case instantiation starts sometime later. When this child case is getting created, automatically this data transform will get executed. It will copy the data from parent to child. So business has given you a requirement to copy the data from parent to child at the time child case is getting instantiated. If you do this logic in PY default data transform, that means you do not have knowledge about OOTP provision. So instead of you writing the PY default data transform, you create your own data transform and call it in the propagation. So this will be executed only when the child is getting instantiated, not at the parent. Parent is created, child is also getting created, immediately it will be executed. Parent is created now, child is getting created after 3 steps of parent. Then at the moment child is getting created, this data propagation happens. Data propagation means copying the data from parent case into child case of given properties, what you mentioned here or what you mentioned inside data transform. But all this data propagation execution happens only when the moment of child case is getting created. Can it happen at the moment same when parent case gets created? Is it possible? It is not possible. Why it is not possible? At least child should be, instantiation starts, then only it should happen. Parent created, you try to copy the data, what is there to receive? There is nothing to receive. That's why parent created, at the same time child is creating, propagation will happen. Our parent created, after 3 steps child is creating, the moment child is getting created, propagation will happen. In anyhow, ultimately, data propagation means copying the data from parent into child at the moment child cases are getting created. Okay? So remaining things I'll tell you tomorrow. These are just basic idea about copying data from parent to child, child to parent, or other case to other case, or propagating the moment of instantiation. All this is available in the documents of case management. Did I share you anything, any document for this? No, right? I will share you now. This video also I'll upload sometime later.